being here, and also all of you on the other side of the screen. I'm Heidi, I'm the producer of this concert, and I would like to warmly welcome you all to the third UNM Festival concert here in G-Liveland. This evening is dedicated to waves in various forms, where it explores the qualities of sound, light, or visuals. We will hear and also see very different sides of electroacoustic music, and actually this G-Liveland is the perfect surrounding for this concert. All of the pieces in this concert are composed by young Nordic composers. The piece that we just heard, and sorry in advance for all my mistakes in pronunciation with the names, it was Bulur by Gunnlaugur Jönsson from Iceland. The piece was performed by Tambero Ensemble. Next we will have an audiovisual piece, Archive, by Frank Ritso, who is representing Finland, which is followed by two pieces from Swedish composers, Adele Kosman's If It Were For Me, You'd Piece Me Up, and Saga Fagerström's Love Lies Bleeding, both using surround sound. After these pieces, we will have a 15-minute break, and then we continue with pre-recorded performance of Norwegian Nora Ellis Stemland's Understatement. Then we will have Icelandic composer Aslaug Magnusdóttir's piece Love and Desire, performed by Demo Quartet. And we end the evening with Swedish composer Anton Berlund's Studio of Lyud och Ljus, performed by Tampere Rå and the light performer Antti Tolvi. So the next pieces will present two very different aspects of electroacoustic music. Firstly, glitch. No, it's not the computer lagging. And secondly, acousmatic music, focusing on the speakers and sound intended to be heard without any visuals. So next one is from, I have to find the name again, Frank Ritso. And I wish you all a very nice evening with us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now 15 minutes of break, after which we continue with 40 minutes more music. But meanwhile, I would recommend you to go and buy yourself a drink and also check out the desk at the front door where we are selling the UNM Festival books and also zines.
Hi, My name is Lauri Supponen, and I'm one of the main organizers of the Ung Nordisk Musik Festival that will take place, in one form or another, at the last week of August in Tampere, Finland. As you can see, I have a guest today. Could you please introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Adele Marsha Kosman, and I am living in Stockholm, Sweden, where I'm finishing my bachelor right now in electroacoustic composition at KMH.
And what are you going to be doing at UNM?
At UNM, I will be presenting one of my multi-channel acousmatic pieces called If It Were For Me, You'd Piece Me Up. I finished this piece at KMH, I think maybe 1.5 years ago. And it has been presented in the Speaker Dome at KMH a few times. And the piece is a lot about exploring and involving rhythmical material, controlling other types of material, and via experimentation around these concepts of rhythm as opposed to maybe complex and thick recordings. I came up with this main theme that it is built around, and that are a discussion between a rhythmical pattern and recordings from a concert that I made earlier with vocals and organ. So those are the main harmonic materials, vocals and organ. And I wrote a short thing about the piece a few years ago, so I think I will just read that out loud. The simple and rigid controls the mass of sound. The rich and colorful bends for the iterations. In mutual understanding, mutual pleasure, the two worlds of material meet. Misunderstandings occur, but at no loss. Between every hit, there is a window, an opening, and in every glance, I have found something new. I have thoroughly searched to find the very core of this place. My findings will be presented in If It Were For Me, You'd Piece Me Up.
The theme of this year's festival is music ecology. What does music ecology mean to you?
Music ecology is for me mainly connected to soundscape composition, and I have been exploring that genre through works of Murray Schafer and Hildegard Westerkamp mainly. And I came across both of the concept of music ecology and soundscape composition through an article by Murray Schafer a few years ago, and where he talks about the music of the environment, and also a specific concept that he calls noise pollution. And this concept really intrigued me, and ever since I've been investigating it personally through various ways of listening, I guess, and combining it with practices of Pauline Oliveros with deep listening. And it was just recently that I both listened to and read works of Hildegard Westerkamp, where she talks about soundscape composition, and also this article mainly focusing on the combination of the two topics, soundscape and music ecology, where she talks about the involvement of composers in this, in environmental issues, and her beliefs in the power of soundscape compositions as a way of involving listeners in, I guess, distant places and distant problems. and I was really also intrigued by that article. So those are my main two connections to music ecology.
Thank you. And see you in August.
Bye.
Thank you.
about to continue, I would ask you please to return to your seats. The piece that starts the second half is Nora Ellis' Stemland's Anti-Statement. After that, we will have Aslaug Magnusdóttir's Love and Desire, and then Anton Berglund's Studio av Ljudoglus. Also, at the moment, we are updating the whole program of this evening to our Facebook event. So if afterwards you would like to remind yourself which piece, then you can find it there. coming to its end. But before that, I'd like to thank you all for attending, one way or another. Also, a huge thank you for all of the amazing composers who put so much effort in all of what we have had the great joy to witness here today. Also, a huge thank you to Tampere Arvon Demo Quartet and live performer Antti Tolvi, who's actually just gonna perform next. And a huge thank you to our tech team from Music Technology Department at Woo! Sibelius Academy, led by Alejandro. As well as G-Live Lab, especially Jarkko and Jani, for all of their help in the production. Then, a few words about tomorrow as the festival continues. So, there is a presentation by Tanja Tieksoa at 3 p.m. Finnish time in Kulttuuritalo Laikku. And in the evening, there's going to be a concert with Tampere Philharmonic Orchestra, Tampere Orchestra Academy, and Tampere Capella at 7 p.m. Finnish time at Tampere Talo. Also, a quick reminder about an ongoing installation at Galleria Koppelo at Kauppakatu 14. And actually, the music continues even after this concert, as at 9 p.m. there's going to be a guitar concert just around the corner in the old church. The concert is part of Tampere Biennale Festival, and the entrance is for free. So, as soon as we are ready to continue, we will continue with Anton Berglund's Studio of Ludoc Lewis. Thank you.
Ett tyst ljus rör sig framåt. Skymtar en rörelse på andra sidan. Vet hur tätheten, massan, flyttar sig. Ett ljud av det som finns ser något en bit bort. Väntar in. Väsnas i sin ensamhet. Sina skiftningar, nyanser, väntar på en rörelse. Ett tyst ljus lyssnar jag noga. Tillsammans på olika platser. Stannar upp, ser på varandra på var sin sida. En spegling. Samma mönster, samma på olika platser. Lyssnar på ljuset som faller. Ser ljudet sänka sig långsamt. Ser det höjas.
Mama.
åt samma håll samtidigt. Nära, utom räckhåll. Var korsas riktningarna? Eller om korsande är möjligt.